Hello everyone, this is Verosho, and welcome to Verosho Plays Lucy, The Eternity She Wished For. Lucy is a visual novel I found on Steam. I think it's about a robot, and about being whether or not she has a soul or not. So without further ado, let's start the game. The Three Laws of Robotics. A robot may not injure a human being or, through inaction, allow a human being to come to harm. 2. A robot must obey the orders given it by the one possessing control or authority, except where such orders would conflict with the first law. 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law. October 12. You. Okay, it's interesting so far. I just want to close my eyes. The thought enters my mind as I walk down a busy street. All the brightly lit digital billboards and neon signs, covered from top to bottom with 3D holograms, emitting various ear-splitting sound effects. They're all giving me a headache. I feel like I could collapse at any moment. This is the display of the IT superpower, Korea. The constant and in-your-face technology underlines our nation's claim to fame. There have been many drastic and all-encompassing changes in the last few years, and being a person who cherishes nature, I despise these changes. That is why I just want to close my eyes. Blinking doesn't change anything. Everything appears even brighter than usual. I might just be feeling a little off. Maybe it's the weather. I decided to take a shortcut to avoid being overwhelmed. It's a place that will take me away from the blinding lights. I've chosen to take my secret path home. It's a pretty standard visual novel so far. Phew. I finally breathe a sigh of relief after managing to escape the chaos of downtown. I half expect ghosts to pop out at me as I make my way through the shady park path. The buildings nearby are all filthy and worn down, with only a few inhabitants around. It seems that I haven't fully escaped all the noises from downtown. The industrial noises from factories and construction work continues to ring in the air, but that's fine. At least my eyes can take a rest. A massive building on the side catches my attention. K Robotics Company Limited. That's probably what it would say on the main gates. Although I've never cared much about this place, I've at least heard of it. They've put out various models of robots which are renowned worldwide. I see them on the news quite often. My classmates are always talking about them. They are especially amazed about their androids. Personally, I don't know much about robots. In this generation, it's impossible to stay away from technology, whether I like it or not. I don't particularly care much about it, though. I'm the kind of person who prefers an analog clocks over digital. pianos over synthesizers, acoustic guitars over electric, and finally, real people over androids. I turned my attention back to the sidewalk. I continued towards the hidden path leading to their junkyard. Naturally, this is a private property, so no one is allowed to enter. But this is nothing for a troublemaker like me. Here it is, the graveyard for all their failed experiments. In the past, I've seen a small tin can-like robot scurrying around and taking apart various objects. Only the more costly parts are recycled while the cheaper ones are turned into scrap. Everything here is automated. There isn't anyone actually watching over the place. Just a guard robot and several worker robots silently carrying out their duties. If spotted by the guard robot, a siren is activated. I've personally never run into any trouble though. After all, robots are fundamentally stupid. Even with the guard robot, as long as I'm a bit careful, I can sneak by without issue. This is where the big company dumps all their stuff. I heard you can find some real goodies from time to time. Only if you're lucky, that is. Pretty sure that guy from my class told me something along those lines. I've already scoped this place out on previous trips. I've never had a good find though. Guess it's just my luck. Or I can't tell what's useful or not. Probably the latter. Since my familiarity with robots is quite poor, whatever. I didn't come here to hunt for treasures anyway. This is only a shortcut home. If I walk straight through the middle, I can shave off almost 10 minutes. The reward outweighs the risk. If only I could just ignore the loud noises and the no trespassing signs scattered all over the place though. I have no reason to care about the piles of scrap around here. As usual, I quickly made my way through the junkyard. However, today was a little different. Something had caught my eye. A faint figure in the distance. I can't be sure, but it looks like a person. In a place like this, a woman. There appears to be an unconscious woman lying on the ground. She's not moving. Maybe she's hurt somewhere. Or something worse. I start to grow a bit concerned. Had I just stumbled upon a crime scene that might end up on tomorrow's morning headline news? I have to find out what is going on. I'm going in for a closer look. I dash towards the fallen maiden to lend assistance, but wait, it appears that I was mistaken. It wasn't a woman that was lying on the ground after all. Nah, I was fooled. But something strikingly similar. Two eyes closed tightly shut, sparkling silver hair. From afar, you could mistake it for a person. Its features are almost lifelike. An android. That's what was lying there. Achievement unlocked. Abandoned robot. Why would you give me an achievement for that? Hey, you shouldn't say that. Don't scare me like that. I've never actually owned an android before. Though I've seen quite a few around me. They say that an android is nearly indistinguishable from a person from just a glance. That's how advanced our technology has become. To prevent confusion, androids are imprinted with serial codes. Each model has its own unique number. I spot the android's code located near its belly. I blow off the dust to get a better look. It reads PIM001, number 1. With a design that I've never seen before. Maybe it's a prototype. It looks brand new. If so, then what it's doing here? Sorry. Maybe this was one of the failed experiments. It's caked with dust from head to toe. All in all, it's a pretty sad sight. It also haven't moved a single inch. Looks like it's out cold. Hey, wake up. Curiosity gets the better of me. I decide to test it out. I do know that voice recognition is a standard feature for all Androids nowadays. Assuming everything is working properly, it should respond to my voice. No response. Hey, say something. Still nothing. Come on, they're gonna cut you open at this rate. I deliver a light kick to the robot's leg. It's Chobits all over again. Upon contact, it starts to show a sign of life. Accompanied by a collection of bleeps and bloops, the arms begin to spasm. Its movements are quite rigid. The scene looks like it was plucked straight out of an old sci-fi film. It's probably running on reserve power. I guess it's still got a bit of juice left. Its unstable movements start to make me feel a bit nervous. The light in its eyes have yet to return. I begin to spot a pattern in its actions. It looks as if it's greeting me with a wave, trying desperately to keep my attention. I glance around. I hear a screeching sound nearby, the sound of metal being crushed. It's probably those little robots doing their jobs. I can tell that they're close. They'll probably reach this place in less than 10 minutes and shred this android into a million pieces. Its existence will soon come to an end. I kind of feel sorry for this thing. I began to sympathize with the robot because I realized just how much trouble it was in. Despite being dusty, it's still in pretty good shape. With a bit of a cleanup, it would look as good as new. If it hadn't been thrown out, it would surely still have been in service. I wouldn't know what this robot was made for, but I wonder why it never saw its debut. All of the labor used to create this robot will go to waste. All of the sweat and tears poured into creating this robot will go down the drain. All of the cutting-edge features it could have offered will never be realized. And as far as I could see, with a little bit of tinkering, it just might become unusable. Half of me is staring at the robot in pity, and the other half is calling me an idiot for doing so. It's not like I really need an android in the first place anyway. I've never liked them. For me to actually keep one at home and use it, it's unthinkable to say the least. And more importantly, I don't know how my father will react to this. I prefer classical music over rock, classical literature over pop fiction, and finally humans over androids. Let's face it, I have no use for an android. Eventually, this robot will be scrapped and recycled for new parts. It's just like how herbivores are eaten by carnivores for survival. Only the strongest survive. And that's the way it should be. Alert! Intruder detected. Damn it, I've been spotted by that guard robot. The most troublesome one. If I hesitate any longer, I'll be caught and taken away. I gotta go. See ya. With those cold words, I make my way out of the junkyard. Nice room you have. I would love to have this room. Ha, there must be something wrong with me. Oh, you brought it home. Even while taking a great risk, I ended up bringing the android home. It's always been a bad habit of mine to act on a whim. I'm already starting to regret it. But I decide to take some time to clean the robot anyway. I'm really surprised though. It looks practically brand new now. I was nervous about cleaning it at first because I thought using water might ruin its chassis. But then again, I would have probably just thrown it away if it broke down anyway. It doesn't look like there are any glaring issues for now. It seems like I've made the right choice of bringing it home. And besides, it wouldn't make sense for such a premium model to be not waterproof. That's not the only problem here though. I can't figure out how to communicate with this thing. Hey, you.
Where?
Its arms began to flail. Show me a trick.
Where?
Come on, anything. If you don't want to be thrown away again, just show me something.
Where?
Don't tell me moving your arms is all you can do. If you don't say anything soon, I'm seriously gonna toss you out.
Where?
I let out an exasperated cry. This was no better than talking to a brick wall. This is why I hate machines. They're stupid. Especially the one in front of me, which in particular seemed to be a million times dumber than the others. I'm starting to get a little ticked off. Why did I even bother with this thing? Don't do something you might regret. This old saying has never been wrong. Now that I think about it, it's probably operating under reserve power. Maybe it just needs a recharge. That might do the trick. I start to get up, but only to pause thereafter. There's another issue. Hey, where am I supposed to plug this cord into?
Where?
I've never used an Android before, so obviously I wouldn't know. Maybe your nose? Maybe it was just my imagination, but its arms seemed to flail more rapidly. Perhaps it was trying to tell me that I'm wrong. I imagined the android with an electrical cord up its nose. It would be quite a sight. Well, it's worth a shot. Alright, come here you. I approach the robot with a 220 volt plug in my hand. Now I could definitely tell that it was panicking. Out of pity, I decide not to push it further. And how should I power this thing? I examine the robot carefully. Maybe I've missed something. It's starting to jerk its body from side to side. It seems like it wants to turn around. Is there something on your back? Taking the hint, I glance at the back of its head. I squint my eyes. Could this be? Upon a closer look, I spot a small compartment at the base of its neck. I remove its protective lid. Inside, I found what looked to be a number of input ports. Bingo! I guess I'll try connecting it to one of these. I drag out the cable from a corner of my room. Without hesitation, I plug it in. Holy shit. Oh my god. Finally a response. It worked. Application 구동. 실패. 실패. Huh? 전력 부족. System protection 기동 중. Application 구동 불가. 절전 모드로 이동. 경고. 소유주가 등록되어 있지 않습니다. 5초 후 소유주 등록에 들어갑니다. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What the heck is going on?
성문 확인. 지금 뭐 하자는 거야?
No, 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 that's not my name, stop it! What? Hold on a second. I frantically latched onto the robot. Oh, you're reading my...
지문 확인. 맥박 정상. 기온 정상. 지문 등록 완료.
Okay. Say what now? I let go of the robot immediately.
시각 정보 스캔. 시각 정보 확인. 이미지 등록 완료.
It's doing a bunch of things, and I don't think it's about to stop anytime soon.
이름을 발음해 주세요. 소유주의 이름은 무엇입니까?
What is happening?
이름을 확인합니다.
Verifying your name.
소유주의 이름은
is what happening, your correct name.
뭐냐? 대체가 맞습니까?
No, it's not. What do you think?
이름 등록 실패. 반복합니다. 이 소유주의 이름은 무엇입니까? 이름 등록 실패. 스테이터스 등록 보류. 완료. 이상으로 소유주 등록을 마칩니다.
Well, that was weird. I started to have a coughing fit all of a sudden. Just like that, all was silent once more. Sorry, I was drinking water. Ugh, I really shouldn't have brought this thing home after all. This is already the third time regretting it today. Why do I keep punishing myself? The robot is facing towards me. Its eyes still retain a vacant look. I wonder if this is supposed to be normal. But at least it has started to move. I decided to throw a few questions at it. Hey, I'm gonna ask you something, so listen up and try to answer. You can do that, right? Its head tilts slightly to the side. I suppose it can move more than just its arms now. It's not much, but at least we're making some progress. Let's do this. So what exactly are you?
말의 의미를 판단할 수 없습니다.
Don't you have a name or something like that?
모델명 루시 발렌타인 PIM001.
I see. Lucy Valentine. PIM?
Precision Instrument for Multipurposing. PIM001. 루시는 기존의 특화 타입에서 벗어나 언제 어느 상황에서든 소유주의 도움이 될 수 있도록 수백 가지의 다양한 경우를 상정해 고안된 다목적 안드로이드입니다.
And why were you thrown away?
여러 신기술들이 집약되어 있습니다.
Versatile. Latest features? I wasn't expecting those words from a piece of junk that could only move its arms up and down a moment ago. In short, your name is Lucy Valentine. The android named Lucy is waiting for my next words. Let's try taking a closer look. Oh, right. It looks as good as new after the wiping I've given it. It possesses an alluring visage and slender figure. Regardless of gender, I have to admit that it truly is a beautiful design. I spot something on its left ear, a receiver. The robot has the appearance of someone in her late teens. I guess they were trying to model it after a teenage woman. I can tell that a lot of effort had been put into creating this android. It'd probably sell for a premium price. It'd be a waste to throw it away. I take a closer look at the android's eyes. They're blue and they look strikingly similar to human eyes, as expected from technology one whole generation ahead of LED lights. Those eyes do look quite real.
Suddenly, the eyes shift over to me. Naturally, I meet their gaze.
알코 형태의 고성능 카메라가 두 개 부착되어 있습니다. 인간과 동일한 감각으로 사물을 감지하는 것이 가능합니다.
Ah, is that so? The way those eyes moved was very unsettling, like something straight out of a horror movie. I decide not to look at them again. They make me feel uncomfortable. I take a gander at the robot's moist, glossy lips. Contrary to their appearance, they projected a harsh robotic voice. Before advertising itself as a first-class model, I'd like to see if it's capable of changing its voice first. What's wrong with your voice? It sounds unnatural.
현재 음성 관련 모듈을 사용하지 못하고 있습니다. 루시 발렌타인은 기본적으로 10가지의 개성 넘치는 음성 프리셋을 지원하고 있으며 각종 이퀄라이저 기능을 내장함으로써 셀 수 없을 만큼 다양한 음성을 파생시키는 것이 가능합니다.
I'm not gonna lie, you are one complicated robot. So basically, you have 10 different voices? No reply. Why can't you use them right now?
대부분의 기능은 정상 모드 및 프로텍션이 해제된 상태에서만 사용이 가능합니다.
I see.
절전 모드에서는 통상의 5% 미만에 해당하는 기능밖에 활용하지 못합니다.
I see. Then how do I get you out of this power saving mode?
최소 20% 이상의 동력 여분이 남아 있어야 정상 모드로 이행이 가능합니다.
How long does it take for a full recharge?
제로를 기준으로 수면 모드 시에 총 8시간, 통상 모드 시에 총 16시간이 소모됩니다.
That's actually pretty quick, you know, considering she's a full-fledged robot that can act like a human. I hope the electricity bill doesn't go through the roof. Can't believe I'm talking like a cheap housewife in front of a robot. It's just silly. Forget about power saving mode. What's system protection mode?
대부분의 기능에 제한이 걸려 있습니다. 통상적인 활동을 위해서는 프로텍션 해제가 필수 불가결합니다.
Well then, how do I deactivate it?
알 수 없습니다.
Come again?
알 수 없습니다. 어떠한 필요성에 의해 잠금 기능이 걸려 있다고 판단됩니다. 푸는 것은 바람직하지 않습니다.
What are you even talking about? You're no better than a talking toaster right now. Do you really want me to throw you out? I'll have to take it to a repair shop first thing tomorrow. When does that place open again? Sorry for clearing my throat up so much. I guess I should have eaten cough drops before I started this walkthrough. I decide to take a look at the robot's ears.
음성 인식 기능을 통해 상대방의 음포, 음색, 음정 등을 분석해 대상의 기분이나 의도를 대략적으로 알아내는 것이 가능합니다.
Damn. I bet you would cost like, I don't know, at least $100,000 if you were sold in real life. I haven't asked you anything yet. I take a look at the body itself. The shirt it's wearing is a little short, leaving out its midriff in plain sight. It's quite exposed overall. This model was probably created to attract male customers. I can't spot any curves in the chest area though. Not that I care or anything. Sure, Mr. Protagonist, sure. Can you move properly now?
모션을 구현하는 대부분의 모조 근육 파츠가 제대로 기능하지 않고 있습니다.
Which ones are you talking about?
Deltoid anterior, deltoid midlet, deltoid posterior, pectoralis major C navicular, pectoralis major lateral, biceps medial, biceps lateral, biceps.
Okay, that's enough. What planet does this thing come from? From now on, try to keep things simple. How are your legs? Can you move?
불가능합니다.
What a pain. I'll have to take it to a repair shop tomorrow. You already said that. I think I'm starting to get the picture now. Let's do a little recap. First, the name of this android in front of me is Lucy Valentine. Second, according to the robot, it's actually a futuristic premium model. Third, as of now, it's no better than a talking tin can. And there you have it. The best course of action right now would be to take it in for repairs. It's going to be a lot of effort, but I guess it's not such a big deal. But come on. Like repairing a robot, I bet that's gonna cost a ton. If I find out that I can't salvage it in any way, I can just sell it off on the spot. I was already doing the android a favor by saving it from those robots at the junkyard anyway. It's not like I feel guilty about it or anything. Okay, time to find a place that can get you fixed. Speaking of repair shops, I've actually heard of one that's pretty close by. Some relatively new place that I've noticed on my way to school. It's an antique shop, but I've heard that they also often deal with robot repairs. Robot. They also don't seem to charge a lot, and many say that they're the ace in the business. I'll pay them a visit tomorrow. Now to decide where when I should go. I guess morning would be best. Yep, sounds good. I'll leave the robot with them in the morning and pick it up on my way home from school. I'm done with my questions. Try to save up some energy for tomorrow.
5초 후 수면 모드로 전환합니다. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good night. Soon as I finish my sentence, with a sudden hissing noise, the robot grows lifeless. I groan as I reach out to catch its falling body. I carefully place it against the wall and straighten out its clothes. Phew! I'm totally drained. I hope tomorrow will be more peaceful. So far so good. I'm really liking this visual novel so far. It's the three laws of robotics again. I don't want to read this. You can read it if you want. It's the same thing, right? May tree, doctor. I've endured this far with just one goal in mind. There hasn't been a single day where I could rest. Hey, this background music is familiar. I think one of the horror RPG Maker games I've played before. Anyway, it's become natural to go to bed at the crack of dawn. I don't recall the last time I've been home. Thinking back, it's been quite a long while. 15 years. 15 years have passed since I've started this project, but the end is near. 15 years of hard work and determination. After all this time, the fruits of my labor may finally be realized. How long have I yearned for this day? I'd almost given up on you many times, but I pushed on though, and I finally succeeded. I barely managed to hold back the tears. I remind myself that it's still too early to celebrate. I must restrain my exuberance. I'm teetering on the brink of a complete exhaustion. I've been pushed physically and mentally to my limit. I've become a shell of my former self. The last 15 years have taken a huge toll on me. I cannot wait any longer. That is why. Please open your eyes. Lucy Valentine. Again? Okay, whatever. Mm-hmm. October 13th, me. Tap. I shut off the alarm by reflex. I groggily get up to check the time. The clock reads 6:30 a.m. School starts at 8 o'clock sharp. It takes 30 minutes to get there, so I have about one extra hour. There's plenty of time left, and I'm still feeling tired. I lie back down. I decide to get some more sleep. After a brief moment, I get back up. I realize that I'd been forgetting something. Come to think of it, wasn't there a... I look around for the android. And there it was, dressed in provocative clothing. With a tall nose, luscious lip, and hair glinting in silver. The android named Lucy came into my view. Lucy. As I call out to her, I'm greeted by an immediate reaction. It seems to be revving itself up. It mutters something and starts to rise off the floor. A robot with looks no different to those of a real person. Also with a pretty face to boot. Don't get the wrong idea. Just because it's attractive doesn't mean I'm interested. Since it's a robot, in other words, it's like checking out a girl from a magazine. Except that feeling is amplified tenfold in this case. Although technology is improving, a huge gap remains between humans and robots. You can't approach a person like you would with a robot, no matter how close a robot could simulate a human being. Machine and man will always be different. As I continue staring at the android, I start thinking to myself, what kind of greeting should I be using here? Good morning? Did you sleep well? They all feel out of place. I decide to ask about her condition instead. How are your battery levels?
100% 충전 완료.
Alright.
문제는 발견되지 않습니다.
I see, that's good. I let out a yawn as I make my way over to the bathroom. Wow, that's a pretty small washroom you have. I wash up, take care of my business, and exit the bathroom. Even my bathroom is bigger than that, man. I like your living room though. It's simple, pretty. After drying myself with a towel, I enter the living room. I spot a couple of plain sandwiches on the table. I pick one up and take a bite out of it. It's always the same sandwich from the convenience store just across the street. While chewing, I'd idly take a look around the living room. I'm actually hungry right now. My father has already left for work. He always leaves early and returns late at night. Actually, it's more common for him to spend the night at work. That's how it is around here. Oh, I'm sorry. I return to my room. The android is waiting for me in the exact same spot. It seems like it hasn't even moved an inch since I woke up. As expected from a robot, I think to myself. Putting that aside, I start to prepare for school. While packing my bag, I start to wonder if the robot has any magical self-regenerating abilities. How do you feel now that you're on a full charge? Are you able to walk? Its head slowly turns to face me.
하체 관절부의 상당량의 과부하를 감지. 통상적인 임무를 수행하기에는 무리라고 판단. 이에 걸맞은 적재적소의 수리가 요구됩니다.
Okay. I told you to keep things simple. Get to the point.
아직 걸을 수 없습니다.
Walking is not feasible in current state. Why did I read that? Still, aren't you a real pain? Anyway, I understand. Even if I wanted to try repairing it myself, I won't be able to tell where exactly the issue lies. There's no choice. I'll see what happens once I take it to the repair shop. I finish up packing. The only thing left to do is to carry out the robot to the repair shop. Alright, how should I do this? How can I put it in my backpack?
Well, if you think you can do it, go.
Sounds good. Come on, get in there. It's too big to fit. Duh. What was I expecting? Should try to use my brain next time.
Hey, you were the one that gave me that option, okay?
Achievement unlocked, reckless challenge. This is probably the best way, right? I kneel down, facing away from the robot. Alright, hop onto my back. It tilts its head to the side, looking confused. After noticing that, I start to get a little irritated. First class model? Yeah, right. Am I supposed to explain every little thing? Listen up. Put your arms around my neck and climb onto my back. Can you do that? After tilting its head again, it spurs into action.
Ugh! Ugh! I knew it! I had a feeling that that lady would have choked him. Stop! I surrender!
The two strangling arms lose their grip. I let out a few coughs. You're trying to murder me? There's no need to put that much force into it. Just do it enough not to fall off. Honest to God, I thought I was actually going to die there. It was a fabulous chokehold, instantly bringing my knees to a collapse. This android should look to be a world wrestling champion. Okay, let's try that again. Second time was the charm. I take a deep breath and hoist myself off the floor. I start to feel the forces of gravity pushing down on my back. Huh? I was prepared to break my back for this, yet surprisingly it wasn't too heavy. I finally come to appreciate this first class product for the first time. Alright, here I go. Alright, let's get to the repair shop and finish it. The weather isn't too bad. The cool autumn wind is brushing against my skin. I gladly let the crisp morning air fill my lungs. It truly cleanses away the stress piled up from last night. The streets are eerily quiet. I'm just glad there are less people right now. Feels like I'm carrying an immature grown-up on my back. It's good that there are very few spectators to witness such a sight. I can at least avoid being the center of attention. Let's see here. I comb through my memories in an attempt to remember the location of the repair shop. If I am correct, it shouldn't be more than 15 minutes away from here. It's a good thing that the shop is nearby. I'm not very athletic to begin with. No matter how light the android may be, I still won't be able to carry it around for a long time. I resume walking, not too light and not too heavy. I maintain the balance of the robot shuffling around my back. Hold on tighter so you don't fall off. It feels like I'm scolding a child. Hey, stop moving around so much. I could feel the surface of the robot through my clothes. It doesn't feel any different from normal human skin. I'd noticed it yesterday, yet it manages to surprise me again today. And it's not just the skin. I can also sense some moderate warmth rising from under the coating. It feels as if I'm carrying an actual person. The robot is probably just overheating itself, which is the reason behind this familiar warmth. Wow. Feels just like a real person. I muttered to myself absent-mindedly. What's this all of a sudden? Oh, that must be why. Motherboards and microprocessors consisting of various computer chips, there must be thousands of those inside a single android. The slight fuzzy warmth emanating from the machine. It's as warm as human skin. It feels just like us. But it's not a real person, just an elaborate fake. Sometimes I fear what progress in technology would bring to the future. Do you know where we're headed? With a word, the robot shakes its head sideways. We're going to a place that'll get you fixed up. When they begin the repairs, you need to be still and quiet, so they won't be distracted. Do you understand? Hey, I'm asking you if you understood. Say something. There's no reply. I just hope it got my message. I let out a small sigh and continued to walk. I checked the time. Classmates will be starting to make their way to school now. I begin to hurry so as to avoid running into anyone that might recognize me. A little while later, I arrive at my destination. Stretching out my mildly aching back, I stand before a small building reminiscent of an antique shop. I've heard that they actually do sell some old goods, but they often deal with something. I'm sorry, I pressed it too quickly. To be specific, it's just the owner's hobby to repair robots. He's not a professional by any means. From what I can find out, they've got a solid reputation though. Most likely, they're better known for repairs than selling merchandise. To be honest, I've yet to hear of another competent place for the job. I don't know much other than that. That's because I've never been here before. I'd only heard about them. This is my first time actually checking out the place myself. Obviously, I wouldn't normally ever visit a place like this, but today is an exception. What? A customer already? Hold on a second. I'm greeted by a grumpy voice full of annoyance. After a while, a man emerges from the back, scratching his head. Oh, hey. He looks as if he's just woken up. He doesn't appear too young or old. Somewhere in his late 20s, maybe. He probably didn't get a lot of sleep last night. He doesn't stop yawning. So what can I do for ya so early in the morning? Unable to move my arms, I gesture at the android draped over my back with my chin. I was looking to get this robot repaired. Huh, an android? Wiping his tired eyes, he passes his gaze onto the robot. Let me see here. I don't think I've ever seen this model before. I spot a glint of curiosity in those sleepy half-closed eyes of his. He walks over to take a closer look. Don't get too close, buddy pal. I can't believe it. Totally stumped. It's probably some obscure model from an unknown company, or it's never actually been released to the public. Where exactly did you get this android? Not sure how I should respond to this. If I tell him about the junkyard, he might call the cops on me, since it's illegal to take anything out of there. Get problematic if I let him in on everything. What should I say? Well, I found it lying somewhere outside. It's the truth, so I should say that. I found it lying somewhere outside. It was the first thing that had come to my mind, and it didn't seem too believable, but it is the truth. What is he gonna say? I found it somewhere. This thing. Yes, someone probably just threw it out, you know? Ha! Well, must have been some rich fella. Robots are typically quite expensive, especially the premium models. Though more common nowadays, it's still a luxury to own one. You don't just throw them away like you would with old toys. It's like saving up to buy a top-of-the-line television. On top of that, if this android really is a high-class model, The repairman views the robot from multiple angles. Now, I don't know where this thing is exactly from, but it's definitely not from the S company. Mind if I take a closer look? Go right ahead. I carefully hand over the robot. The repairman examines it meticulously from head to toe. The android stays completely still. Its eyes are staring right at me. Good thing I told it to stay quiet before we got here. PIM. Ah, must be from the K-Robotics. That might be an anime if you guys, you know, robotic notes. I suddenly grow a bit nervous. There shouldn't be any company labels on it. I decide to play dumb, quite confident in my ability to keep a straight face. K Robotics, did you say? Yeah, they're at that huge building over there. You've probably heard of them, right? They're the ones who made this particular model. How can you tell? I don't recall seeing any labels or anything. It's the android's build. K Robotics is the sole company worldwide that's capable of producing robots of this caliber. But something's not right. The repairman gives a closer examination of the android. You could say that I'm pretty experienced in this line of work, but I don't think I've ever seen this model exhibited anywhere. Are you sure, like, the only child of that company's president? Or... are you like, the only child of that company's president or something? No. And I guess you really did find it somewhere. Consider yourself damn lucky. Not a single bit of information has been released about this model yet. That's how new it is. It appears that I've hit the jackpot. It sure doesn't feel like it though. But wait, what's this? A nasty frown forms on his face. Is something wrong? This is problematic. Suddenly, he starts fussing like a little kid. What kind of sicko would do this? Just look at it, the whole frame's ruined. It won't even be able to move around properly on its own. He was right. That was pretty quick of him to point that out. I guess he really is the real deal after all. Do you think you can fix it? That's not the main issue here. There's something more important. What is that? Do you have the resolve to take proper care of an android? The resolve? What's he suddenly on about? Listen. Androids break easily. They're fragile. They're sensitive. They're delicate. Do you get what I'm saying here? You should never treat an android this way. He emphasizes his point 3 times. That's how passionate he was about it. I can see that he really loves his robots, but at the same time, he's starting to freak me out. Continues to rant. To a lot of people, androids are nothing but fancy toys nowadays. I mean, those kinds of folks pay for my food and my bills. But whenever I hear about how they've been mistreating their androids, I tend to lose my temper, you know? They don't understand how important these creatures really are to us. I unwittingly take a small step back. Creatures? This man just referred to androids as creatures. It's not right in the head. From time to time, people who fall in love with androids would show up in news reports. I'm not just talking about the ones who seek sexual pleasure from androids. You guys should know that. No, I'm just kidding. I'm talking about the people that are willing to spend the rest of their lives with androids, treating them as equals. It's a pressing issue that's been brought up many times in recent years. It's an abnormality spawning from an advancing civilization with constant innovation in technology. As someone who's never seen it happen firsthand, I've always refused to believe it. How could such people possibly exist? An android simply lacks the intellect to be paired up with a human being. It's nothing but a glorified hunk of metal that can make our lives a bit easier. I'd rather spend my entire life with a monkey. These monkeys are actually living creatures, and they share a lot of similarities with us humans. This is the first time I've had something like this happen before me, although I feel more disappointed than shocked. He seemed like a perfectly normal person on the outside, but they say you can't judge a book by its cover. You understand? What I'm trying to say is that I'll get it fixed, but you better take good care of it. I felt this was a bit unfair since I wasn't the one who messed up this android in the first place. Even so, I don't feel like it's worth starting an argument over. Better to just bite my tongue and get this over with. Alright, I just need to be a bit careful from now on, right? Keep that in mind. Yeah, what a great kid. At least you listen when someone tells you something. If you like me that much, could you charge me a bit less? If you're learning to bargain already, at your age, you're not such a great kid after all. He does a full turn in the blink of an eye. Unbelievable. Well, fine. Since you're my first customer of the day, I'll only charge you half is a lot of money. I'm relieved to hear that. Any discounts are most certainly welcome. It's great. Would you be able to finish it by the end of the school today? Yep. I don't particularly have anything else to work on today, so... He punches some numbers into his calculator, and he shows me the results. I was planning on charging you only about this much. What do you think? My mind goes completely numb for the next 3 seconds. Yeah, that's what I expected. There are a lot of video games that I've always wanted to buy. I also need to save up for new textbooks that I'll be using next year. This robot had better pay for itself. Fine, I'll have it ready when I return to pick it up. I take out the pocket watch that I always like to carry around. I've wasted too much time here. Some people ask me why I still bother using such an outdated type of watch in our generation. I tell them that it has a nostalgic charm to it. I'd take this over to those common wristwatches any day. I'm well aware that these type of watches are hard to find, but more importantly, this is my personal way of rebelling against this continuously developing society. Hey, you piece of junk. Hey, can't you hear me? There's no reply or any kind of reaction. I finally decide to address it by my name. And by name. Lucy. The robot reacts instantaneously. How troublesome this thing is. I'll be back after school. Behave yourself, alright? The android wobbles its head back and forth. I'm hoping it understood me. I leave the shop and head straight for to school. Oh man. This game is dialogue heavy. I just can't keep up. My throat is already killing me. I make my way towards the high school that I attend. I'm currently in my second year. While running, a movie that I'd recently watched springs to mind. It's an old sci-fi movie set in the year 2050. Sci-fi movies from the past are quite remarkable. They all seem to lack creativity. Some would include large-scale space battles, others would have vehicles flying through the sky. That's just too unrealistic. It's true that there have been major strides in science and technology, but it's difficult to change what we've grown so accustomed to. In this year of 2050, people still walk to school, people still drive normal vehicles, people still ride bicycles and skateboards. Some people still use old fountain pens or pocket watches like me, but there exists a single piece of technology that's become more prominent in our lives. Androids. Androids are being used everywhere around the world. That is the only difference our contemporary world has to offer. I see. Let's go! Woohoo! I enter the hallway just as the morning bell starts to ring. Giving it all I've got, I make a dash for my classroom. Please refrain from running in the hallways. A janitor android scolds me lightly, and I easily brush it off. These types of androids have facial recognition capabilities that allow them to report troublemakers, knowing that I keep my face well hidden while running past the android. Exploiting their weaknesses is my specialty. As a result, I've never gotten into trouble at school. Safer. I enter the classroom, acting like a professional baseball player who just stolen the base. I notice that the teacher hasn't arrived yet. I plunk down in my seat while still huffing. That was pretty close. Did you sleep in again? I hear a familiar voice calling out to me. It's coming from the guy sitting next to me. A clever-looking fellow. People usually refer to him by his nickname, Dr. Gears. That's because he's a real geek with a burning passion for robots. I, on the other hand, despise robots. And while I'd label myself an introvert, he's very approachable and outgoing. Moreover, our tastes and hobbies differ quite a lot. But he's actually my best bud in the entire class. Puzzling, isn't it? Even our classmates find it strange. No, I just had some business to take care of. Really? This early in the morning? It's a long story. Unfortunately, I'm cut off by the sound of the classroom door opening. A middle-aged man makes his entry. It's the teacher. A female assistant android is trailing behind him. Let's talk about this later. I send him a signal. He returns a thumbs up. Ching! I'm sorry if I'm not making much commentary other than reading the dialogue. It's because it's pretty difficult for my throat to just read the dialogue like continuously, you know, consistently. So I try to take like the times between the pauses, like to just, you know, take a short break, but yeah, you get the point. So lunchtime arrives in the blink of an eye. Take out my freshly brought pieces of bread and arrange them upon my desk. I prepare to enjoy my lunch with Dr. Gears. Two desks have been joined together. On my desk there are a couple of pieces of fried croquettes and a carton of chocolate milk. On his desk there's a tasty looking lunchbox. My friend appears to be enjoying his lunch. I've heard that his maid android makes it for him every morning. But how's the actual food? Doesn't look half bad. For someone who eats bread every day like me, it's truly a feast for the eyes. Why are you just sitting there? Got a problem with your food? Ah, no, I should start eating. I receive a light scolding. I take a piece of croquette into my mouth. As I delicately bite into its golden crunchy surface, a warm savory scent fills my nose. Sweet flavor of the dough mingles with the tantalizing aroma, creating a heavenly mixture. But that's not all. The crema, I don't know, inside unleashes its softness as it slowly melts on my tongue. Then the vegetables in the mixture provide a strong, rich flavor. The eggs and mashed potatoes also join the fray, blending in pleasantly with all the other ingredients. This refined taste, it must be. Just a plain old piece of croquette. You made me read that much dialogue and you just said that it was a plain piece of croquette? How about fuck you? I'm just kidding. I put it aside and casually ask Dr. Gears a question. By the way, didn't you once tell me that you have a lot of androids at home? Huh? Yeah, six of them in total, I think. Six of them, huh? What an impressive number. It's impossible for normal households to be able to afford that many. The rumor has it that he's from a rich family. Guess it's true. Where's this coming from all of a sudden? No. Oh, wait a minute. He starts grinning like an idiot. Hey, your food's falling out of your mouth, you know. You've taken a liking to androids, haven't you? Have you finally decided to put an end to this war between us? Well, for now, I guess. A wise decision. Androids are simply amazing, you know. They're truly the greatest invention that science has delivered since the beginning of mankind. There are a lot of different types, but I would recommend the maid models above all else. They take care of all the chores and really know how to cook. On top of that, the female ones are all pretty cute. Sometimes I find myself admiring their beauty. You've got one sick twisted mind, Gears. Don't you know that people can achieve inner peace with beauty? It's been proven by science, you know. I shake my head warily. I do admire his enthusiasm over something so petty though, really. Look, I just care more about what's on the inside, that's all. What are you talking about? I'm saying that it doesn't matter whether they're pretty or not. I just hate robots in general. Here's an example using people. Let's say there's a person with a pretty face, but he's a man. Does the fact that he's got a woman's face change anything? No, he's ultimately a man. Likewise, even if I see a beautiful android, since it's ultimately a robot, its aesthetics don't matter anymore. It just becomes an illusion. What I'm trying to say is that even if a robot acts like a person, it's not. Therefore, all robots are the same to me, and I dislike them all. I guess you still haven't changed your mind. But there has to be a reason why you brought it up, right? Normally, you wouldn't ever talk about it. Well, yeah. If you're looking to buy one, I'm here for you, man. I'll make sure to fill you in everything you need to know. I'm telling you, you'll be making the greatest purchase of your life. After those words, I couldn't help but scratch my cheeks. I'm not exactly looking to buy one. Could it be that you're worried about the price, my friend? Don't worry, I have some connections that'll let you have one dirt cheap. As long as I'm with you, there won't be any problems. No, it's not that. There's no need to buy one. Now just what do you mean by that? I fidget around, not knowing whether if I should tell everything. I found one somewhere. Found what? An android. You found one? An android? Yeah. Where? At the junkyard. Holy, you lucky bastard. Is it something like an IDX358? Or 455? What model is it? Something that starts with a P. Can't remember. Someone told me it's a pretty recent model, but I haven't seen anything impressive yet. Might as well give it some time though. It was free after all. Now you've made me curious. I'll be sure to pay you a visit soon. He pauses for a moment before continuing, as if he's trying to change the subject. Well, I'm certainly happy that you've taken an interest in androids, but... But what? But you should be careful. About what? You've seen them on TV lately, right? Those who are obsessed with androids, they say it gets really tough to deal with as time goes on. Robots are robots, humans are humans. You should never forget this boundary between them. Robots are mere tools designed to make our lives easier. Nothing more, nothing less. Damn, this guy has it. Like, he knows what he's talking about. You'd be better off worrying about the chances of being struck by lightning. Does he even realize who he's talking to? What an absurd idea. I know, of course. I don't expect that to happen to you of all people. But it doesn't hurt to be a little self-aware, you know? Better safe than sorry. Alright, I get you. I'll keep that in mind. He nods in response. Okay. Before I knew it, it was already time for the final class of the day. At last, another monotonous day of school was coming to a close. But it feels as if this lecture will go on for eternity. Time seems to be inching along at a turtle's pace. The chalkboard is filled with scribbles that are barely decipherable. Makes it much more difficult to understand the lesson, which is already painfully tough to begin with. Ugh. I can't take this anymore. The teacher is also awful at explaining things. His words go through one ear and right out the other. Unable to hold back the incoming fatigue, I let out a small yawn. Looking around me, it doesn't seem like anyone else is doing much better. All the unreasonable pushy teachers have something in common. They never explain anything in the simplest way. They always make everything seem more complicated than it needs to be. A bunch of rotten snobs, that's what they are. Nothing in this world lasts forever. The teacher's dreadful onslaught of words ultimately comes to an end. Watching a politician give a speech is probably much less infuriating. All that's left now is to go home. Time to get out of this place. Feeling like a prisoner who's just been set free, I quickly pack up my belongings. I wave goodbye to Mr. Dr. Gears and head home. How long is this game? On the way, I suddenly realized something. I'd completely forgotten about my android at the repair shop. I almost ended up heading straight home. I double back towards my new destination. I arrive at the shop. By looking through the windows, I could see that the place isn't too busy. There are just a handful of people wandering about. But the repairman himself, I can't find him. Without hesitation, I enter the building.
Antique shop에 어서 오세요. 손님, 뭘 찾으시나요?
As soon as I set my foot inside, I was immediately greeted by a female staff. The voice had a sweet, vibrant texture. It really caught me off guard. I'd never expected the girl to be manning the stall. I guess she's a part-timer. I turn around to face the person calling out to me, and my jaw drops to the floor. You. It takes a while for her to recognize me, but when she finally does, her face lights up instantly.
Oh, 드디어 와주셨군요, 주인님. 애타게 기다리고 있었답니다.
This is gonna be a hell of a ride, guys.
It was the android named Lucy Valentine who had greeted me at the door. Are my eyes playing tricks on me? There's no way that useless thing could be standing there talking to me. There isn't any hint of awkwardness in her smile. To reaffirm my suspicions, I check once more. Lucy. You're Lucy, right?
네, 맞아요. 루시는 다른 누구도 아닌 루시랍니다.
Lucy 담이다? I was correct, it seems. What happened to you?
네, 주인님. 어떻게 된 거냐고 하시면...
That voice, and your face, and you're standing on your own, right?
네, 물론이에요, 주인님. 루시는 지금 두 발로 서 있답니다. 에헴!
Lucy puffs up her chest, looking proud. I mean, that's not really something to be proud of, but thinking back to how she was before, it was damn well impressive. You do look better now, so there's nothing wrong with you anymore.
네, 주인님. 지금 루시는 몸이 가벼워서 날아갈 것만 같답니다.
After those words, she does a little ballerina spin in place. She had the appearance of a mature, well-pampered maiden, yet at the same time looked silly like a child. But her spin abruptly ends as she crashes to the floor. And there goes my peace of mind.
아직 원 상태는 아닌 모양이에요.
Lucy smiles sheepishly. While that's going on, I'm staring at her with loss for words. Her perfectly natural, non-robotic human voice. Her personality full of rich human emotions. Her face showing all kinds of believable expressions and reactions. And her freely moving arms and legs. To say that I'm amazed would be a gross understatement. I'm so amazed that I'm lost for words. My brain has turned to mush. My vocabulary has all but been forgotten. I wouldn't show it on the outside, of course. Losing control of your emotions reveals your weaknesses. Well, honestly, it's not just because of that. I also didn't want to admit to her that I was surprised. What a change in a matter of few hours. This is amazing.
처음으로 주인님한테 칭찬을 받았네요.
Oh god, so...
<laughs> So
it's gonna be like this, huh? I'm complimenting the guy who fixed you up, not you.
그럴 수가...
The look of disappointment on her face was quite surreal. How can I plausibly explain this? Magic? Had she been enchanted by a witch? Old stories from childhood come to mind. The nine-tailed fox who decided to become human. The little mermaid who also wished to become human. What happened to them? They never ended up fulfilling their own wishes, but this robot makes me think. If that little mermaid's wish ever came true, wouldn't she be celebrating just like this? Alright, enough of these silly thoughts. I should be looking for the repairman. But the problem is, I've already spent some time searching and he's nowhere to be found. Say, what happened to the guy who put you in charge?
네, 주인 아저씨께서는 필요한 물품을 조달하러 잠깐 외출하셨답니다.
He's not here. What about his store?
에헴, 가게는 지금 훌륭한 점원이 대신 보고 있답니다.
An assistant? Where?
에헴, 에헴.
What is she even talking about?
Ahem, ahem.
I don't see anyone.
Ahem, ahem.
Lucy, who once stood tall with pride and confidence, is now almost broken down in tears. I wish she'd stop flipping through all these different emotions. But feeling bad for her, I decided to drop the act. Okay, I get it. You're the one in charge for the time being.
네, 맞아요, 주인님. 지금은 루시가 가게를 보고 있답니다.
Her expression changes faster than the speed of light. Her sadness from just a moment ago has long left the earth in a rocket. But I honestly can't believe this guy. Leaving Lucy to take care of the store on the first day he's met her? Especially to such a ditzy robot. You need to have a few screws loose to think that this would be a smart idea.
저, 주인님, 뭘 그렇게 생각하시나요?
I'm not thinking about anything. Can you stop calling me master all the time? It's obnoxious.
하지만 주인님은 주인님인걸요.
Use my name instead.
하지만 루시는 주인님의 이름을 모르는걸요. 이 기회에 가르쳐주세요.
Right. Come to think of it, I'm pretty sure I failed the last time I tried to tell her my name. How about I just tell her whatever that comes to mind?
Are you kidding me?
Vero Show? I have an even better name. The name's Mr. Fuck You Game.
주인님, 그런 거짓말은 하면 안 된답니다. 남을 속이는 건 나쁜 짓이에요. 거짓말은 죄랍니다.
So you're telling me I'm ugly?
아, 그런 뜻은 아니고요. 실수, 실수.
She curls up instinctively, thinking she might be scolded for messing up.
그게 아니라 이름을 속이면 안 돼요. 진짜 이름을 말해주세요.
How absurd. Upon what basis are you claiming that your master is not telling the truth?
조금 전에 이름을 입력하는 걸 봤답니다.
Oh, come on. Even the game's working against me. Ugh, I don't even care anymore. Just call me master.
네, 주인님.
Weirdo?
주인님.
What?
주인님.
What do you want?
그냥 불러봤답니다.
Are you messing with me?
아니요, 아니요. 당치도 않은 말씀을. 주인님이라고 부를 수 있는 분이 있다는 게 너무 기뻐. 그래서 그냥 불러봤답니다.
Sorry. An enormous smile blooms over her face. How could she have such a dull personality? Was she still broken somewhere? Or was she purposely designed to be so laughable? Maybe she's on drugs? Totally. Do drugs for robots even exist in the first place? I come up with a list of possibilities, but obviously I wouldn't be able to find the answer. The point is that I can't seem to keep up with the robot's pace. Where's the repairman when I need him? About 10 minutes later, the repairman finally returned. To tell you the truth, I was planning on approaching him first. But I never got the opportunity to do so. Because the moment he saw me, he threw away everything in his hands and charged towards me like a madman. Then he gripped both of my hands tightly. Please let me have Lucy. What kind of screwed up situation is this? He looks as he's asking his girlfriend's father to let him marry her. I immediately announce my decision. No, I will not let you marry her. Eh, what are you on about? You hire something? That's my line. What do you think you're doing? He only takes some time to collect himself. Perhaps that wasn't the best way to put it. Kid, would you ever consider selling me that android? This was completely unexpected. You want me to sell her? Yeah, I can give you this much. He takes out his calculator and shows me the figures. My mind goes numb for 5 seconds. Are you serious? Of course. What do you think? Not a bad deal for a student, right? Not even adults can easily find this kind of money, you know. Looking at the state of this old building, I wonder if he can really afford to spend that much. He's overexerting himself for sure. I stare at Lucy in silence. She seems to be frozen in place. She probably wasn't expecting this to happen. She returns a pained, somber look. I could almost picture a miserable kidnapped slave about to be shipped out to the sea. Come on now, that's a little rude, don't you think? It's not about to eat you alive or anything. I turned back to face the repairman. We paid this much. Do you really think Lucy is worth that kind of money? Of course! He yells in excitement that scared me. Felt like my eardrums were about to pop. Listen carefully. Any decently priced robot model comes with an AI, or a module that allows them to mimic human emotions. You know this much, right? Yes, somewhat. But creating such a module is an extremely and incredibly complex process. even then, you know how well they perform? To compare them to a real person, they still seems a long ways off. Exactly, no matter how much effort we put into making these modules, they can only copy humans in the most basic sense. It's not yet possible for them to feel or to think or to express emotions on their own. I think I'm beginning to see the picture here. Looking back at Lucy, I start to put together what he's trying to tell me. Oh, you're a sharp kid, aren't you? They teach kids pretty well these days, so what do you think I'm trying to say? Duh. Basically, you're telling me that Lucy is an exceptionally intelligent robot that is capable of processing natural human emotions, correct? Honestly, I was quite surprised about that as well. I've never seen such a robot that could emulate a real person so well. Even the new models nowadays reveal their flaws after a minute-long conversation. But I couldn't sense anything particularly out of place while chatting with Lucy. It felt like just talking to a real person. To put it simply, this is a person made out of metal, a human robot, an iron maiden, a revolution in the robotics industry. The guy who created Lucy must be a true genius. That aside, good thing he caught himself before calling Lucy a certain power armor wearing superhero. Nobody likes patent infringement lawsuits. Totally, not on YouTube. Anyway, if she was such a spectacular robot, would she really be thrown away like that? I'd actually found something weird. There was some sort of built-in protection feature that was stopping the robot from working properly. Protection feature? I vaguely remember what that was. The useless junk version of Lucy might have said something about it yesterday. Whatever it was, she seems to be doing fine now. And you removed it? Yeah, it wasn't too difficult, since it was just one of those you put on display models. I'm just curious as to why they would bother doing such a thing before throwing it away. He appears to be lost in thought. It might mean the inventor wanted to keep this new technology sealed away from humanity. If not, then maybe. What if there was a serious bug? That's what I thought too, so I ran some tests but found nothing. It's safe to say that she won't be harming anyone. Why would she ever want to harm people? She won't be posing any threat to people at the very least. I'm just saying that she probably obeys the three laws of robotics. The three laws of robotics. Again, one robot may not injure a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. Two, a robot must obey the orders given it by human beings except where such orders would conflict with the first law. 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law. These laws allow us humans to keep the robots in order. They make sure that humans will always have authority over robots. Major catastrophes can be prevented as long as these conditions are properly met. Properly. I've heard that if a robot ever disobeys one of the laws, it would immediately shut itself down under any circumstances. That's why there aren't any glaring flaws to this system. I shift my focus back to the numbers printed on the calculator. Then I look back at Lucy. She's emitting the gaze of a forlorn puppy, causing a prickling sensation upon my face. After a moment's hesitation, she seemed to have made up her mind about something. She slowly makes her way towards me.
"말씀 좀 실례합니다만..."
What's wrong?
암묵적 용도로 만들어진 루시는 정말 무궁무진한 방면으로 응용이 가능하답니다. 분명 어떤 일을 하더라도 엄청난 도움이 될 수 있을 거예요.
Yes, and?
그러니까 저...
So what?
저... 그러니까 저...
I never get tired of seeing Lucy look so depressed. What kind of sadistic guy are you? Yeah, it seems to have unleashed a hidden sadness within me. She was trying her best to show off her charm. Essentially, she's a self-advertising product. You don't see that every day. But willing to go this far for me, it'd be too cruel to let her go at this point. I'm not gonna make deal, so don't worry. As I finished the sentence, the looks on their faces were different as night and day. The repairman sulks while Lucy breathes a sigh of relief. Anyway, she's good to go now, alright? Here's the money. With quivering hands, I take out some bills from my wallet and hand it over. My money. The repairman hesitates for a moment, but finally takes it with a bitter look. For now, yeah. But be careful not to put any strain on her legs for a while. It's okay to move around the house, but she should avoid any extended periods of walking. So I need to carry her home on my back again? I guess it can't be helped. She's not too heavy, so I can manage. Well, that's it for today. Thank you. His eyes are filled with regret. He really doesn't want to let Lucy go. But I flat out ignore him and prepare to leave. I'll be sure to pay you another visit if something else comes up. Okay, but make sure to treat her well. And don't overwork her too much, alright? See you later too, Lucy. You can come visit me anytime. The look on his face while waving back goodbye to Lucy was truly a spectacle. This time, he seemed to be the father seeing his daughter leave with another man. Guy's completely out of it. I've definitely made the right choice by keeping Lucy. Sorry if my me reading the dialogue is starting to sound sloppy. I've been recording for over an hour and a half, so, you know, takes a big toll on your throat. We exit the shop and take a short stroll until we reach the sidewalk. I stop in my tracks. Silence, I kneel down facing away from Lucy. Hop on. I add an explanation to make sure that she understands. That means you lightly put your arms around my neck and climb onto my back. Not like last time, Jesus Christ.
저 주인님, 혹시나 해서 묻는 건데요.
What is it?
저 바보 취급하고 있나요?
Yes. I guess I no longer have to worry about being choked to death. I feel her weight gradually shift onto my back. For a robot, she's very light. She was probably measured to weigh as a normal girl. Huh?
왜 그러세요?
No, it's not. Ah! As soon as she climbs onto my back, I can't help but notice a fragrant aroma rising from her body. It's neither too intense nor fleeting. It gently spreads evenly along my nose. It starts with a sweet, fruity scent reminiscent of a youthful girl, yet there is a hint of spice akin to a mature woman. It doesn't fail to stimulate the mind of a teenage boy going through puberty. What the fuck? This is bad, I've never experienced something like this. It didn't happen this morning, but why now? It's probably because of the smell, it wasn't there earlier. Feeling a little faint, I desperately try to get a grasp of the situation.
주인님, 왜 그러시나요?
Yes, you are exactly like a real person. How the fuck is that happening? The person who must have created you must like have a time machine or something from the year 3000. Anyway, she's measuring my heart rate. It's not fair. I feel a little embarrassed for revealing that I'm a nervous wreck right now. Unable to hold back, I decide to be honest to myself. The smell, what is it?
Aha, 이 냄새 때문인가요? 아저씨께서 여러 가지를 선물로 주셨답니다. 여자아이니까 자기 관리는 스스로 해야 한다면서.
She takes out a bottle of perfume amongst many other makeup accessories. Geez, that guy is scary, really scary. He's the type of person who'd spend a whole day forcing his pet dog into different clothing. If you'd consider that as animal abuse, wouldn't this be some kind of robot harassment? Well, I don't know. All this stuff just for a robot. What a silly guy. Why are you laughing?
그냥 웃음이 나와서요.
Had I just been seduced by a robot? Well, there goes all of my dignity as a human being.
무겁지 않으신가요?
What are you going on about now? I purposely try to sound irritated. It doesn't affect her in any way, however.
유씨의 몸, 무겁지 않으신가 해서요.
You're heavy as fuck, asshole. Of course you're heavy. Why even bother asking?
쿵. 어쩌죠? 주인님에 어울리는 갸름한 로봇이 되도록 다이어트라도 시작하는 게 좋을까요?
You already know that's impossible. Unless you're planning to tear your insides out or something.
너무해요. 분위기 좀 내본 건데.
After that, Lucy started to sulk a little. It was very much a natural human-like reaction. Very womanly, too. I don't know how am I supposed to react to this. She's leading all of my values and beliefs astray.
She's meeting all of my expectations!
She's just a robot. Just a robot. I repeatedly warned myself. Achievement unlocked. Shivers. Soon enough, the streets became immersed in the orange glow of something, 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 something. The scenery was changing more slowly than usual today. Maybe it's because I'd been carrying Lucy on my back. But it's not that a lot of time had passed. Winter was just on its way, as evidenced by these increasingly shorter days. Lucy hasn't said anything for a while. Steal a glance at her, wondering if she's asleep, but she's not. She appears to be lost in thought, staring at everything in sight. She looks like a child inside a pleasant dream. I can see her eyes sparkling. Is it really that fascinating?
뭐가 말인가요?
This place.
아, 네. 정말로 근사하다고 생각해요.
I can't say if I agree with that. Unlike downtown, there aren't many distractions here to keep us busy. Nor are we near any beautiful landscapes. We're just walking down a plain old street that you can find anywhere. What part of this place do you find marvelous?
전부 다요.
Everything.
네, 전부 다 근사하답니다. 예전에는 나들이를 나갈 때 항상 허가가 필요했으니까요. 밖에 나가서 이런 식으로 길을 거닐 기회가 몇 번 없었거든요. 그래요. 굳이 말하자면 이렇게 움직이는 동안 주변 경치가 변해나가는 것이 근사해요. 루시가 모르는 풍경이 또 다른 모습으로 변해가는 모습이 이런 식으로 천천히 거리의 모습을 둘러볼 수 있다는 사실이 그런 것들이 무척이나 신기하답니다.
I see.
정말 근사하다고 생각해요.
You said the exact same thing I said. I couldn't relate to the sensation she just described. What is it?
정말 죄송합니다.
What's with you all of a sudden? Caught off guard by the unexpected apology. Had she really done anything wrong?
루시가 오늘 너무 떠들었죠? 죄송해요. 원래 성격은 사실 조금 침착한 편으로 제작 과정에서는 남을 이해할 줄 아는 넓은 포용력을 메인 컨셉으로 삼고 설계되었습니다만.
I found it strange how Lucy was telling me what kind of person she was supposed to be. If anyone other than Lucy had told me the same thing, I'd probably have laughed at them. Anyone by himself will never be able to find out what kind of person he truly is. Sitting in front of a mirror reveals all the flaws of your body. Sitting in front of a person reveals all the flaws in your personality. If you ever want to find out something about yourself, it needs to be reflected back to you by something else. That is why attempting to describe your own personality is same as describing what kind of person you'd actually want to be. It'd just be a bunch of pretentious nonsense. But this is the only case for humans. Lucy is an android. She's not human. That's why it doesn't sound strange coming from her.
분명 처음으로 주인이 되는 사람을 맞이해서 기뻤던 걸 거예요. 오랜만에 기동이라 그런지 상당히 들떠있기도 했고요.
It was such a natural explanation about how she felt. She was happy to meet her first master. And she was happy to be able to finally move around again. You've never served anyone else before?
네, 주인님께서는 제 첫 번째 주인님이세요.
Is that so? So she's a new model that no one has ever touched. That line of thinking sounds dirty, but that's not what I meant.
연구소에 있을 때
Viewers, that's not what he meant.
거기 계시던 모든 분들께서 제게 잘 대해주셨거든요. 여러 가지 화제를 얘기하고 또 여러 가지 것들을 가르쳐 주셨지요.
A lab, did she say? Oh, I'm sure they treated her well.
뭔가 재미있는 대답을 하거나 지시한 행동을 수행할 때면 많은 분들께서 기뻐해 주셨답니다. 특히 기대에 착실하게 부응할 때는 루시는 참 똑똑하구나 하고 머리를 쓰다듬으며 칭찬을 해주시곤 했어요. 루시는 그게 너무 좋았어요. 신이 나서 더욱더 많은 것들을 배웠고 더욱 많은 이야기들을 했어요. 그럴수록 점점 더 많은 귀여움을 받았답니다.
They were probably just testing her abilities. In my mind, I found the whole scenario unsettling. To Lucy, however, it's the treasured memory of her past. But there is an important question yet to be answered. Then why were you abandoned? I've always been meaning to ask her, but I can't easily bring myself to do so. I ask myself why. Maybe it's because I'm starting to care about this robot's feelings? I shake my head. It's just plain nuts. It's only because she sounds just like a real person. It's a dangerous thought. Let's get it out of my head. I blurt out the question. Then why were you abandoned? Oh, right. Sorry. I start to regret asking the question.
다들 루시가 싫어진 거라고 생각해요.
Oh, come on. With those words, Lucy finally breaks the silence.
언제부터인가 다들 루시에게 웃어주지 않게 됐어요.
But why?
다들 루시를 칭찬해주지 않게 됐어요. 다들 루시의 메인 시스템을 가동시켜주지 않게 됐어요.
Is it because they made a better robot or something?
예비 전력을 통해 흘러가는 시간만을 감지할 수 있었어요. 아무것도 하지 못한 채 그저 시간이 흘러가는 것만 느낄 수 있는
Okay, that is kind of sad.
그게 느껴지던 그런 나날이 그리고 그러던 어느 날
Lucy goes silent once more. Then one day, she found herself left in the dust, is what she probably wanted to say. Maybe they didn't like something about her, or they found a significant flaw within her design. But I don't like the fact that they had just tossed her aside after giving her so much love and attention. Aren't they being too inconsiderate? Yeah, after giving the robot feelings, Jesus Christ. A small rage boils inside of me, directed at those cruel researchers with no sense of responsibility. When I regained my senses after a few seconds, I became surprised at how angry I was. What was I thinking? They were just throwing away a failed experiment. The object on my back is nothing more than an impressive fake. She's not real. She's not a living creature. It's only natural that useless machinery is thrown away. There's no need for me to be so angry.
주인님, 다시 맥박이 올라가고 있습니다. 무슨 일이신가요?
It's nothing. Stop measuring that all the time.
하지만 자동적으로 체온을 재도록 프로그램되어 있는데요.
Then it's an order. I order you not to measure anything from now on.
명령이신가요? 그렇단 어쩔 수 없네요.
There's another silence, but this time not an unpleasant one.
그래서 주인님에게는 너무나도 감사해 하고 있답니다.
I just can't seem to figure out this robot's train of thought. What?
버려지고 얼마나 오랜 시간이 지났는지는 알 수 없어요. 하지만 루시의 체감상으로는 정말 오랜 시간 동안 버려져 있는 것 같았어요. 주변은 어두컴컴하고 사람의 인기척이라곤 없었어요. 아주 어두웠어요. 아주 고요했어요. 아주 외로웠어요.
Great, now you're hitting me in the feels, man.
그러던 도중 주인님의 목소리가 들려오기 시작했어요.
I don't remember talking to you like that.
그래도 루시에게는 정말 천사의 속삭임 같았어요. 아무것도 없는 어둠 속에 처음으로 빛이 떠올랐어요. 루시에게 여러 차례 말을 걸어주셨죠?
You're overreacting. She's definitely going overboard with this. I just happened to notice her while casually passing by.
주인님의 눈에 띄기 위해 필사적이었어요. 있는 힘을 다해 몸을 움직였어요. 그랬더니 글쎄, 움직이지 않던 손이 움직이는 거예요.
There were only a few words which didn't contain any significant meaning. And it was only on a moment's whim that I'd taken her home. But I was surprised those simple actions were such a big help to the robot.
루시를 걷어주신 것 정말 감사하고 있어요.
Being able to say the most embarrassing things without hesitation. I guess that's one of the advantages of being a robot. I can feel my face beginning to flush. I quickly duck in order to hide my embarrassment. Shut up. I'm gonna make you pay for what you're worth. So you'd better be ready for it.
네, 주인님. 각오하고 있답니다.
What's so funny? Why do you keep laughing like that? It's creeping me out.
모르겠어요. 아까부터 웃음이 계속 흘러나와요. 고장인가 봐요. 어쩌죠?
It's called joy. Learn it sometime, protagonist. Lucy quietly rests her cheek against my shoulder. The sensation of her soft skin causes me to flinch. She feels very much different compared to this morning. It feels as if I'm carrying a real person on my back instead of a robot. I start to wonder what could be causing this difference in perception. Was it just a placebo effect? Or had something really changed since the morning? If something really did change, was it me or the robot? I continued to ponder over the question on the way home. I never managed to come up with an answer. October 13. Are you? Alright. You know guys, I've been recording for quite a while. I don't think like my commentary can keep up. I mean, my throat can keep up much of this commentary, so I'll end the first episode here. I'll be doing the second episode very soon, so don't worry. I plan to make these episodes at least like 1 hour and 30 minutes long, since it's a visual novel, so you guys can enjoy all of the content that's gonna come soon, so. Right. There's no background music. How about I save? There. I save, help log, load options, title. Alright. Now, so that was Lucy, the eternity she wished for, part 1. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Stay frosty, y'all.